So in the last class, we discussed about list and tuple, right? One second. In the last class, we discussed about list and tuple and some of the attributes of list and tuples we have discussed. Okay, sir. Basically, now both are doing same job, but where is the difference? What is the difference between list and tuple? List versus tuple. See, basically, lists are mutable. Basically, lists are mutable. Tuples are immutable. That means, once you create a list, if you want to update an element, that is possible in list. If you want to update an element in tuple, that is not possible. Okay? Lists are immutable. Sorry, lists are mutable and tuples are immutable. In tuple, once you create a tuple like this, 101, like probably something like this, some 9000 salary, okay? If you create a tuple like this, if you want to update a particular element, like I want to replace this 101 with 102, I want to replace like this, then that is not possible. That is what we call as immutable objects. Basically, tuples are immutable, okay? Lists are mutable. That means in the list you can update an element. That is not a big deal. And coming to the second difference, there is a append method is there. So that we can add elements. In the list, if you want to add an element, that is possible. There is a append method. In tuple, there is no such kind of method. In tuple, there is no such kind of method. There is no direct way in order to create, in order to add an element into the tuple. There is an indirect way. That is, you have to collapse the previous tuple and you can add. We have already seen that in the last class. Right? Like this. Suppose some T is there. T is a tuple. Okay? If you want to add an element into the T, then just you need to say T plus something like this. 100, 900 like this, okay? This is what we call as collapsing the previous one and creating a new one. See, you don't collapse a tuple every time in the real world. See, observe this one. Suppose you have created a tuple in server 1 or system 1. Second, in server 1 we have a created tuple. You have created one tuple. This object memory address is referred to some other system. This object memory address is referred to some other system. So every time you are collapsing this tuple, every time you are adding a new element, every time you are collapsing means, what about the server one, server 2? The server 2 will be disturbed, right? Okay? That is why people are not using tuples to add in elements. To dynamically change in purpose, people are not using tuples. Because every time it is collapsing, every time creating a new object. That is very bad for real world. That is why people are not preferring tuples to dynamically changing data. For dynamically changing data, people are not preferring tuples. Okay, so there is no direct way. Without collapsing tuple, it is not possible to add an element into the tuple. Without collapsing the tuple, it is not possible to add an element into the tuple. Simply say, tuples are static in nature, or you can say fixed in nature. Whereas come to list, lists are dynamic in nature. Okay, lists are dynamic in nature. You can delete, you can add, you can perform anything. But when come to the tuples, tuples are static in nature, sir. Fixed length. If you are going with a fixed length data, then you can go with the tuple. If your data is continuously updating, then go with list. Okay, preferably I would prefer lists for homogeneous data. Okay, as per Python recommendation also, lists are for homogeneous data, tuples are for heterogeneous data, and which contains a fixed in nature, fixed length. Okay, fixed length of data, we are going with tuples. These are what the basic differences between lists and tuples. Okay, I'm going with the next data type, that is set. Set is one data type. Okay. If you see the Python documentation, the set definition is like this. Set is a collection of unordered unique elements. This is what the definition that the Python documentation contains. Set is a collection of unordered unique elements. Okay, unordered unique elements. What is that unique elements? We will see that. Okay, set values must be enclosed in a flower bracket like this. Okay, 10, 20, 30, 40, like this. Sets must be enclosed in a square bracket, that means, sorry, flower brackets, curly braces, you can say that. A set is a collection of unordered unique elements. What is that unordered? Try to understand this one. So I'm creating a tuple, sir. In the tuple, I'm passing my data in some order like this. If I say print of t, you will get some output. Whatever the order you pass, same order you will get, sir. Whatever the order you pass, same order you will get in the output. But when come to the set, suppose I pass data like this. When I query my set, you will find a random order. That is what we call as unordered. Okay? So, whenever you pass the data in some way, but at the end, when you query the data, it may be in random order. You cannot say that. this order it must be like that. Okay, you cannot say that. Instead, the elements will be displayed in a unordered way, random way, you can say that. Now, what is this second one? Unique elements. A set is a unordered, sorry, a set is a collection of unordered unique elements. What is that meaning? Suppose I am creating a set 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, again I am passing 40, again 40, again 50, again 10 I am passing. So if you see, how many unique elements are there in my set? 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. All the remainings are duplicated elements. So only 5 unique elements are there. 5 distinct elements are there in my set. Now if you query your set, only the distinct elements will be displayed. What about the duplicate ones? Duplicate ones cannot be displayed because sets does not allow duplicate elements. Okay, so this is what we called as a set. A set is a collection of unordered unique elements, or you can say random ordered unique elements. Set always contains unique data. Okay, set always contains unique data. On sets we cannot perform indexing operations. On sets we cannot perform indexing operations. What does it mean? Suppose tuple t is there. If I say t of 0, what you will get? You will get the first element from the tuple. Some set is there. If I say s of 0, what you will get? You will get an error, because the elements are not arranged in a proper way. The elements are, okay, are arranged in a unordered way, random way. That is why sets are not supporting indexing concept. Sets are not supporting indexing concept. Okay, list and a tuple are supporting the indexing concept. Sets are not supporting any indexing concept. Okay sir, now observe this one. Some set S is equal to there. I want to add an element into my set. Suppose I want to add 70 into my set. Then there is a function called add. Add is the function which is used to add an element into the set. Like this. S dot add. I'm saying 70. Now 70 is added. Now observe this one. S dot add. I'm saying 40. 40 is already there. Now what about this one? This won't be added, sir. Just observe your set. Because 40 is already there, it won't override the previous data. Okay? Just before entering the duplicate element, it just validate the data. Whether that element is already there in my set or not. Just validate it and it will, okay? It will allow this value. If it is not there, then only it will allow the value. If it is already there, then it will just ignore that value. Like this. S dot add of 10, I am saying. 10 is already there in my set. So what it will do? It will validate this 10 is already there or not. Yes, it is there. Just it will ignore that value. It is not overriding, sir. It is not overriding. It just ignore the new value. Okay. So sets contains an attribute called add. which is used to add an element. I want to remove an element from the set. Then there is a function called remove. Remove is the function which is used to remove the element from the set. Like this, s dot remove. I want to remove some 70, then 70 will be deleted. Okay, so in remove you need to pass the element value. So remove will accept element value. So by using element value, you can delete the element from the set. I want to update this one. 20 I want to replace with some other 55. That is not possible in set. I want to update this one. 20 I want to replace with 22. That is not possible in sets. Sets are basically immutable. Sets are basically immutable. Okay, so we cannot update the data which is there in the set, but I want to update this one. I don't want 20, I want 22. Then first you need to remove that element, then s dot add 22. This is the only way. Okay, you cannot directly update the element. There is no update operation, there is no indexing operation. So how can you update the elements in set? Okay, there is no direct way, there is only indirect way. That is, first you need to remove whatever the element you don't require, then you can add your element by using add attribute. Okay, sets are basically immutable. That means you cannot update the data in sets. So there is one more function called set. Set is the function which is used to create empty set. Or we can convert other data types into sets. Two usages for this function. Set is used to create an empty set, and second usage is we can convert other data types like list, tuple, such kind of data types into sets. Okay, you'll see that. I want to create an empty set. Just s is equal to set. This is the one way. I want to add elements into the set. S is now empty. S dot add of 10. Now 10 is added. Like this. Suppose there is a tuple t is equal to 10, 20, 30. 40. I want to convert this tuple into set. Sum s1 is equal to set of t. Now if you query s1, it will be converted into set. Now my tuple contains some duplicate values like this 10, 20, 30. 30, 40, 50, something like this. Now if I convert S1 is equal to set of T. Now observe the S1 results. Even though your tuple contains duplicate elements, your list contains duplicate elements, it won't consider the duplicate elements. Okay, it will consider only the distinct elements. So basically the usage of set function is two usages. One is in order to create empty set, then the other usage is you can convert other data types into sets by using set function. I want to create an empty list. How to create an empty list, sir? There is two ways. One is square brackets and second one is by using list function. I want to create a tuple. There is two ways. One is this one and second one is tuple function. Two ways. Okay. I want to create set. There is only one way. Empty set. There is only one way, set function. What if I place flower brackets like this? Some x is equal to flower brackets if I say. This is not a set, this is a dictionary. Just observe this one. This is a dictionary, that is not a set. Okay? So in order to create empty set, there is only one way, that is this one. So basically, what is the use of these sets? Sets are basically used for set analysis. Sets are basically used for set analysis. Set analysis is nothing but the comparisons. Comparisons. Okay? So what is this comparison? Just observe. I have set 1, S1. Which contains some data like this: Ravi, Raj, Kumar, Deepak, Sandeep, like this. I have some data like this. Okay, I have some set two, which contains Raj, Ravi, Ram, Arvind, Arun. This is set one. That is set two. Okay. Now, what is set analysis? First, try to understand this data set. S1 is the set which contains top 5 customers in sales. Sales wise, top 5 customers. Set 2, top 5 customers by profits. Okay? I want to know, these are the top 5 customers by sales. These are the top 5 customers by profits. Okay? I want to know who are the common customers between these two sets. That means the customers who are giving both sales and profits. So how to find this? If you see my data, Ravi is there in my S2 also. Raj is also there in my S2. Sorry, this is capital. Ram is not there. Arvind is not there. Arun is not there. So who are the common customers? The customers who are giving both sales and profits. Who are those customers? Raj and Ravi. Those are the two customers who are giving both sales and profits. Okay? This is what the conclusion from your sets. So Ravi and Raj both are giving, okay, both sales and profits. Those are the two customers who are giving sales as well as profits. So how to find this? How to find this? How to find this result? By using set attributes, or you can say set functions. The functions are like this: intersection, union, difference, symmetric difference. These are the set attributes we have. Okay, intersection, union, difference, and symmetric difference. So if I perform intersection operation between these two sets, then you can get Ravi and Raj details, right? Ravi and Raj details. If I perform intersection operation between these two sets, then you will get Ravi and Raj information, right? You can answer this query by applying intersection operation over these two sets. Okay, that is what the advantage of your sets. Let's see how to perform intersection operations. Suppose S1 is there, S1 is equal to some Ravi Raj. What is the third one? Kumar. Deepak. Sandeep. Like this, I have one set. Set 2 is equals to Raj. Ravi, Ram, Arvind. Arun. Like this I have set it. Okay sir. Now how to perform intersection operation? S1 dot intersection of S2. You will get the common elements between the two sets. Now if you say S1 dot union of S2, same output you will get. Sorry, union operation. Union operation you will get. Okay. Now if you come to difference, so how difference will work? Let's see that. This is set 1. Imagine this is set 2. This operation we call as a intersection. This is set 2. Sorry, set 1, and this is set 2. This operation we call as union. So what is difference? Difference means either left only or if you want right only, then you can achieve right only, not a problem. If you want only right only, then you can achieve, not a problem. Okay, I want left only, then S1 dot difference of S2. If I say this, S1 is treated as left set, S2 is treated as right set, then you will get only left only. if I say S2 dot difference of S1, then S2 is treated as left one, S1 is treated as right one. Okay, then you will get this one. Okay, so which set you want to treat it as a left one or right one, then you can choose that one, not a problem. Okay, S1 or S2. So now, what is symmetric difference? Symmetric difference means except the common elements, remaining all elements. This is what we call as symmetric difference. Symmetric difference means except the common elements, remaining all elements I want. Then that is what we call as symmetric difference. So how to achieve symmetric difference? S1 dot symmetric underscore difference of S2. Sorry, spelling wrong. Something is S1 dot symmetric underscore difference of S2. Symmetric S2 is not defined, cap not capital S2, it's a small s2. That is symmetric difference. Okay, except the common elements, you want the remaining all elements, means this is the way. Okay, there is one more way is there in order to create this kind of, you know, operations by using operators, set operators. By using set operators, we can achieve same results. So what are the set operators? And C is for intersection. Pipe symbol, which is for union. Next one, minus is for difference. Next, cap symbol is used for symmetric difference. Now observe this. I have set 1 is equals to something like this. S2 is equals to something like this. 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, something like this. Now if I say S1 and S2, you'll get something like this. S1 pipe symbol S2, then you'll get a union operation. S1 minus S2, here the left one is S1, the right one is S2, so you'll get left only. If you say S2 minus S1, you will get only this one, the elements from S2. Okay, now if I say S1 cap S2, you will get symmetric difference. This is how you can achieve. Which one you prefer, that's your choice. Okay, I am comfortable with operators. I'll go with operators every time. Okay? Now my question is, here set lengths are same, right? What if my set lengths are different? Like S2 is equals to, I am overriding the previous data, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100, something like this. Now set 1 length is different and set 2 length is different. So what if I say S1, S2, same we'll get, okay? S1 dot intersection of S2. Okay, even though the set lengths are different, here set 2 length is something like 7, set 1 length is something like 5. Even though set lengths are different, still you will get the output. Okay, don't worry about the set lengths. That's about your sets, sir. Okay, so is there any questions in sets? Please let me know in the chat window. That is what I explained. You know, sets are basically used for set analysis. Sir, for last week classes, just write a mail for this one. Satya.com, something like this. In sets, you cannot say in which order it is going to add it.